area was all bush. Yes, it was ARDA, Mr. Drummond and Mr. Nabaza came together and said, let us clear this area. And they cleared over 360 hectares of land. And they still have a balance of about 197 of land to be cleared. And in clearing that land, they were able to produce in 2017, 20 hectares of potatoes, 30 hectares under cherry pepper, 25 hectares of tomatoes, 75 hectares of soya beans, 26 hectares of maize. They also put a lot into infrastructure, rehabilitating offices, rehabilitating houses. They put under irrigation 300 hectares under irrigation. And they also were able to purchase tractors, pumps, and various farm equipment. That is a significant, and we as a bank want to work with those who want Zimbabwe to succeed. And I believe that our partnership with Mr. Drummond and ADA has been one of those successful partnerships, which we will definitely want to expand. We are already working with Mr. Drummond in many other projects, not just here. We also work with them with Sunset Marketing in Bulawayo, Drummond Ranching in West Nicholson, Drummond Poultry in Bulawayo Eskwadini, and Drummond Masola in Mapisa. So there are a number of projects that we are working with, and we are keen for others to come on board and say, let's work together and do public-private partnerships. It's not about collateral or security. It's about what you can produce. Your cash flows will determine the ability of banks to finance you. And we are very comfortable that we will be repaid based on production, not based on what you can take as collateral in the form of housing. We also will continue to support, and in 2018, we have already provided support, and they are growing 80 hectares of soya beans, 75 hectares of cotton. And again, they are also working very closely on the value chain financing side, working with Canes Foods for tomatoes, working with Best Food Processors for tomatoes, Sunset Marketing for the supply of grains. So this is really what we need to do as Zimbabwe. Focus on exports. This economy needs to generate exports. We need to reduce on our import requirement so that our balance of payments can be in surplus. We need to increase production because we want to be self-sufficient. And ultimately, we must once again become the breadbasket of the region. And that really is what I want to leave you with and say, see what has been done here. We can replicate this elsewhere and achieve our status of being the breadbasket of Zimbabwe. Thank you.